India is known around the world for its history, cultural heritage and diversity. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. A famous writer of Indian origin, Siddharth Kattrigadda, once said that the greatness of a culture can be found in its festivals. And so, the greatness of a country like India can be examined by sparing a glance at the vivid and vivacious list of festivals celebrated here. Ranging from harvest to the one dedicated to several gods and goddesses, the country celebrates number of festivals throughout the year. One among them is the festival of Chhat that was recently observed with much fanfare across various parts of the country.
Observed on Kartik Shukla Shashti, Chhat Puja that traces its origin to prehistoric Vedic times has gained a special significance as a folk festival. Dedicated to Chhati Maiya, also known as Shashti Mata, and Surya along with his wives Sandhya and Usha, the four-day festival holds immense significance for married women who observe fast and stand in waist-deep water to present religious offerings to the sun god. The rituals and traditions of the festival are very hard as the devotees had to fast for 36 hours without a single bite of food or a drop of water. This year, due to the coronavirus, many people came up with different alternatives to avoid visiting ghats and observe the festivals at their home itself.
हम लोग हर प्रत्येक वर्ष हम लोग ब्रह्मपुत्र किनारे में जाके सूर्य अर्घ देते थे और छठ पूजा को पूरा परिवार के साथ मनाते थे, पर इस बार जो महामारी पूरे विश्व में आया हुआ है, साथ में हमारे असम गुवाहाटी में भी, तो इसका पालन करते हुए हम लोग पूरा परिवार अब विचार किए हैं आपस में कि क्योंकि मेरे पिताजी सीनियर सिटीजन है, 65 साल से ऊपर उम्र है, मेरी मम्मी का भी करीब 60 साल से ऊपर उम्र है और छोटे बच्चे हैं, इन सब के ऐतिहासिक बरतते हुए हम लोग इसको अपना घर में ही छठ पूजा करने का मनाए हैं, जिसके हम छत पे एक छोटा सा टब बनाए हैं और सारा लोग सब परिवार यहीं पर छठ मनाएंगे।
Celebrated with immense zeal and enthusiasm, the festival lasts for 4 days. On the first day, also known as Nahai Khai, devotees take a bath, particularly in the river Ganga, and bring the holy water of the river to make prasad at home. They also cleanse their houses and eat vegetarian food to protect the mind from the vengeful tendency.
आज के दिन हम लोग गेहूं धोते हैं घर में, अपना साफ सुथरा करके कद्दू दाल सब्जी सारा नियम पूर्वक से नहाए खाए का व्रत का शुरुआत करते हैं।
On the second day, also known as Kharna, devotees make offering that comprise of kheer, puris, chapatis and bananas besides observing fast for the whole day. These items are then distributed to the family and neighbors after worshipping Chhati Maiya. The toughest is the Sandhya Argh, the third day of Chhat, when devotees, mostly women, observe a rigid fast where they neither consume water nor food. Evening, they go to the bank of the river or pond, carrying along with them a dowry, a basket made up of bamboo sticks, in which they keep the offerings that comprise of thekua, puri, coconut, banana and other seasonal fruits. After this, devotees offer Sandhya Arg to Sun God with their families.
इस पर्व का महत्व यही है कि मतलब सब परिवार इकट्ठा होकर हम लोग करते मनाते हैं, सबको सुख शांति मिलता है, घर में बरकत होता है, मतलब जो मांगते वो पूरा हो जाता है।
उषा अर्ग मार्क्स द फाइनल डे ऑफ दिस होली फेस्टिवल ऑन व्हिच डिवोटीज गैदर एट द बैंक ऑफ द रिवर अर्ली इन द मॉर्निंग टू मेक ऑफरिंग्स टू द राइजिंग सन, following which they break their fast. During all the 4 days, devotees observe purity and live frugally. They thank Sun God and his wives for showering blessings and sustaining life and energy on earth.
छठ के महत्व होता है, हम लोग औरतें 3 दिन व्रत करते हैं माँ खष्ठी देवी के, बहुत खुशी से हम लोग व्रत करते हैं, छठी मैया हम लोग का मनसा पूर्ण करती हैं।
छठ इज कंसिडर्ड एज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट एंड ऑस्पिशियस फेस्टिवल्स इन नॉर्दर्न बिहार एंड इन पार्ट्स ऑफ द नेबरिंग उत्तर प्रदेश एंड झारखंड। With time, the festival has also gained popularity in metropolitan cities as people from these states migrate in large numbers to make a living.
India is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. So, today we take you to the Dargah of Hazrat Sayyid Afzaluddin Amir Ma in Uttar Pradesh that has been serving as a bridge between different castes and communities.
An epicenter of faiths, a place where brotherhood and bahami between many religions have flourished and prospered. The Dargah of Hazrat Sayyid Afzaluddin Amir Ma, situated in a small town in Uttar Pradesh, is one such melange of diversities. Situated in Baharaich district, the shrine witnesses a rush of devotees throughout the day. Whether one is a Hindu, Muslim, Sikh or from any other community, devotees come here to offer their prayers to the Sufi saint who propagated the messages of righteousness and truthfulness.
हजरत अमीर माँ जो दरगाह है, यहाँ पे भारी संख्या में हिंदू मुस्लिम आते हैं। उनका अपना अकीदा है, यहाँ पर लोग आते हैं, उनकी मुरादें पूरी होती हैं और सबसे अधिक संख्या में यहाँ पर हिंदू की तादाद आती है। शहर में जितने भी लोग हैं या आसपास के लोग हैं, वो हर जुमेरात को यहाँ एक मेला होता है, उसमें शिरकत करते हैं और भारी संख्या यहाँ अगर देखने को मिलती है तो वो हिंदू मुस्लिम दोनों की एकता की मिसाल जिसको कहते हैं, वो इस दरगाह पे देखने को मिलती है।
It is believed that Sayyid Afzaluddin is the 7th generation of Imam Hussain, who was the grandson of Prophet Muhammad. Devotees believe that the saint died around 670 years ago in the year 1350 AD. Ever since, devotees have been visiting this dargah in order to seek the blessings of the revered saint. It is believed that the Sufi saint fulfills the wishes of all and nobody returns empty-handed from here. The dargah also observes Urs annually when people from different religious communities throng the dargah to seek his blessings. The shrine showcases religious tolerance by drawing people from different faiths who leave aside their differences and pray for peace and harmony.
मीरमा है ये, यहाँ पे हमें बहुत मतलब यहाँ पे शिफा हमको बहुत ज़्यादा मिलती है। जब मैं यहाँ रोज आता हूँ तो हमें इतनी आनंद मिलती है हमको कि क्या है क्या नहीं है। हम तो यहाँ के लिए यह इतना अच्छा दरबार है कि यहाँ हमको बहुत ज़्यादा सेवा मिलती है। यहाँ बारिश आता तो हिंदू आता है, रोज़ आता है, हम तो रोज़ आते हैं। और बाकी जुमेरात वाले दिन हर आदमी आता है, हर हिंदू आता है यहाँ पे।
The Dargah of Hazrat Sayyid Afzaluddin Amir Ma is a perfect example of communal harmony that is witnessed throughout the length and breadth of our country.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Navies of India and US participated in advanced air operations in the Arabian Sea as part of the Quad Grouping military exercise with Japan and Australia. Indian Navy's aircraft carrier was seen participating in the drills along with Russian origin MiG-29K aircraft. US Navy's F-18 and AEW aircraft E-2C Hawkeye also participated in the exercise. The Navy's also conducted coordinated firing on surface targets undertaken during Phase 2 of Malabar 2020 exercise. India, the United States, Japan and Australia began their largest joint naval exercises in over a decade earlier this month, seen as a part of efforts to balance China's vast military and economic power in the region.
Night shelters, which offer blankets and a place to sleep, are giving the homeless in New Delhi some respite from the cold wave that has been tightening its grip on the city. People were seen wrapping themselves in blankets and sleeping at a night shelter of the city as they protected themselves from the cold.
कंबल अंबल जो है कि एकदम अच्छे से दिया जाता है, मोटा कंबल, और हर वक्त आते थे सामान बटने के लिए, जिसे सरकार के द्वारा अच्छी सुविधा यहाँ पे।
The occupants of the night shelter are also provided with mask and sanitizer to prevent the spread of the coronavirus.
Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison and his Indian counterpart Narendra Modi stressed on cybersecurity at the Bengaluru Tech Summit 2020. Addressing the summit virtually, Morrison said technology holds the keys in finding solutions to global challenges like carbon emissions and climate change. Indian Prime Minister called on the bright minds of the country to help in devising cybersecurity solutions and ward off cyber attacks and viruses.
A lot of it. Technology, we believe, holds the keys to new science, medical research, reducing carbon emissions, addressing global climate change. It's now at the forefront of foreign policy, security and defence. It's pushing us to new frontiers in civil liberties and governance, whole new fields of law, in data protection and privacy. The scale and pace, well, they're immeasurable. That's why it's more important than ever for countries like Australia and India to work together on these challenges and opportunities.
With the rapid increase of tech use, data protection, as well as cyber security become very, very important. Our youth can play a big role in devising robust cyber security solutions. These solutions can effectively vaccinate digital products against cyber attacks and viruses.
The theme of the year 2020 summit organized by the government of Karnataka state was Next is Now.
Authorities in Jammu and Kashmir cleaned the iconic Dal Lake to make it a pleasant sight for the tourists that are expected to descend into the valley in the coming months as the government eased coronavirus lockdown restrictions. The cleanup operations are conducted every year as the lily pads cover large swaths of the lake and hamper the movement of shikaras or houseboats and hide Dal's aesthetic beauty.
लिली ग्रोथ है ये लगभग 6.5 square kilometers में स्प्रेड हो गया है ओवर द ईयर्स. इसको एक्सट्रैक्ट करने के लिए ये मशीन हम यूज़ कर रहे हैं और पिछले 2 महीने में हमने ऑन एन एवरेज पर डे 2 shifts में चला के लगभग 90 के आसपास हमने डंपर्स डेली बेसिस पे निकाले हैं इसमें.
The Lakes and Waterways Development Authority, Kashmir, employed workers and high-tech machines to undertake the cleaning drive of the lake, the beauty of which has been marred by the filth floating on the water and moss and weed growing inside it. Dal Lake is integral to tourism and recreation in Kashmir and is named the jewel in crown of Kashmir or Srinagar's jewel, with Shikara houseboats being a major tourist attraction for decades in the beautiful Kashmir Valley.
India has a fabulous tradition and culture of giving. In an impressive finding by the Charities Aid Foundation, it has also been found that the number of Indians helping a stranger, giving money and volunteering their time is more than any other country. Example of one such Good Samaritan can be found in Hyderabad city, who for the last many years has been providing free lunch to the poor every day, irrespective of caste or religion.
In a bid to ward off hunger woes, a Hyderabad-based man, Asif Hussain Sahil, has been providing food and other raw food essentials to thousands of people continuously for the past 10 years. He's also the founder of a voluntary organization named Sakina Foundation, which he established in the memory of his late father and daughter in 2010. During the lockdown, his organization distributed food to around 10,000 people on a daily basis for about 3 months, no matter which caste or community they belong to.
खाने का तो काम हम पहले से ही करते थे, बट अब रेगुलर बेसिस पे 365 डेज ए ईयर हर दिन जो है सो खाने का खिदमत पिछले 10 साल से शुरू हुआ, जिसमें मेरी वाइफ और मेरे वालदा पहले दोनों खाना बनवा कर हम घर पे बनवा कर जो है सो बांटते थे. अब तो काफ़ी बढ़ गया है, पहले 100 आदमी से शुरू करे थे, अब अल्लाह करम से हज़ारों लोग तक खाना हम पहुँचा रहे हैं और डिफरेंट एरियाज़ में हमारे किचन चल रहे हैं अभी फ्री किचन. डेली दोपहर का खाने का इंतज़ाम किया जाता है. ओके, लॉकडाउन में तो देखिए हम एक तो डेली 10,000 के करीब ऑन रिकॉर्ड खाना हमारा गया है यहाँ से पिछले 3 महीने में. अभी तो राशन का डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कर रहे हैं, खाने का कर रहे हैं और मुख्तलिफ एरियाज़ में छोटे से किचन स्टार्ट किए हम लोग ने. हर यूनिट जो हो सके, मतलब लोग को इतनी दूर आना पड़ रहा था, इस वजह से हमने क्या किया, 4 zones में हैदराबाद को डिवाइड कर 4 zones में हमारे किचन मुख्तलिफ एरिया में हमने किचन को स्टार्ट किया है. अभी
Sohail and his family are actively involved in this volunteering work, and every day between 2 to 3 p.m. they start their distribution service. The packets are kept at one place from where the needy people can pick as many as they want. Along with food, Sohail also distributes masks to those who don't have one.
ये टाइम नमाज के बाद आके खाना लेके जा रहे, चार 5-6 साल से तो लेके जा रहे.
क्या रहता
खाने के लिए? जो जुम्मा चिकन का सालन खाना रहता, अब रोज दाल खाना खिलाते.
रोज Recently, Sohail even received a letter of appreciation from West Zone Commissioner A.R. Srinivas for serving lunch and dinner packs to thousands of migrant laborers in the West Zone area of Hyderabad. People like Sohail are truly an inspiration for the society to rise above religious lines and help those in need.
It's been said, in every work of art, the artist himself is present. The land of Jammu and Kashmir has a history of producing some of the best painters, artists and craftsmen in the country. The new one to join the list is a self-taught young Kashmiri artist from Srinagar who is excelling in making mandala artworks and is turning out to be an inspiration for other aspiring artists in the territory. Have a look.
Home to a number of different indigenous art forms, the Kashmir Valley has produced some of the best artists and painters in the history of Indian art and craft. Hailing from Srinagar district of Jammu and Kashmir, Soliha Qureshi is a self-taught artist who has excelled in making mandala artworks. Showing keen interest in art and crafts, Qureshi started making these artworks at a very young age without any formal training. She even started participating in art and craft competitions and realized her interest and talent as an artist.
आर्ट जर्नी मेरी शुरू हुई जब मैं थर्ड क्लास में थी और तब से शुरू हुआ और मैंने तब कॉम्पिटिशन्स में पार्टिसिपेट करना शुरू किया और वहाँ बाकियों का आर्ट वर्क देख के मैं काफ़ी ज़्यादा इंस्पायर हुई बट टिल टेंथ मैं ज़्यादा इन्वॉल्व नहीं थी इस चीज़ को लेके बट देन प्लस टू में मुझे थोड़ी गाइडेंस मिली थोड़ा सपोर्ट भी मिला और फिर शुरू हुआ जब फोर्थ क्लास में एक सब्जेक्ट हुआ करता था हमारा ये बट तब ज़्यादा सीरियसली मैंने इस चीज़ को नहीं लिया बट जब मैंने कॉम्पिटिशन्स में पार्टिसिपेट करना शुरू किया और वहाँ अपने लेवल के जो बच्चे हैं उनका काम देखा तो उस चीज़ से मैं काफ़ी ज़्यादा इंस्पायर हुई कि जब ये कर सकते तो मैं क्यों नहीं कर सकती
Apart from making mandala and other forms of artworks, Qureshi is also pursuing her bachelor's degree in economics honors. She has maintained a proper timetable so that she could properly manage both her studies as well as her passion. Apart from winning a number of art and painting competitions, including a prize from Department of Handloom and Handicrafts, Jammu and Kashmir, Qureshi has also worked with some reputed film production houses as a storyboard artist and an art director. Qureshi's friends and family are extremely proud of her endeavors and hope that she continues to inspire more youngsters in the valley.
सोलिहा में वो टैलेंट है कि वो अपने आर्ट से शोकेस कर पाती है काफ़ी सारे इश्यूज़ को वो हाईलाइट कर पाती है कि जो हम बोल नहीं पाए या जो हम ऐसे वोकल होकर लोगों तक पहुंच ना पाए वो ये अपने आर्ट के थ्रू पहुंच पाती है लोगों तक
तो आपको लगता है कि इसको देख के बहुत सारी लड़कियां
बहुत इंस्पायर बहुत यूथ इंस्पायर होता है क्योंकि आजकल का यूथ ज़्यादा इस चीज़ में जाता नहीं है लेकिन इस चीज़ सोलिहा के इस आर्ट से बहुत ज़्यादा यूथ को ये मैसेज मिलती है कि अगर कोई आपके में कोई टैलेंट है आप में कोई चीज़ है जो आप हैं तो आप वो इजहार करें आप वो दिखाएं लोगों को कि हम में ये टैलेंट है या हम ये कर सकते हैं
Mandala arts are geometric patterns, diagrams or drawings that represent the cosmos metaphysically or symbolically. Qureshi thinks that these mandala arts represent the connection between humans and the universe and is also a creative expression of life. She aims at creating more artworks that not only reflect this divine connection, but also highlight the various issues that are often ignored.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@nin.com. I'm your host, Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.